So I've been using the Galaxy Note 2 for a couple of months, and it's the perfect device, sitting in between a small phone or a large tablet, fits in my pocket, nice and versatile, great for media, great for gaming, a brilliant all-rounder. But now you've got your Galaxy Note 2 and it's Christmas Day, well, what kind of things can you do? Well, the first thing you're going to want to do is hit the Play Store. And you're going to want to go in here and you're going to want to just update any of the apps you might already have pre-installed. You'll normally get a little notification, but if you press your soft button here, you can also go into My Apps and it will show you a list and you'll be able to update any of those. Make sure all of your Google apps are up to date and you've got all the latest WYSI features, etc. Always worth doing. Then you're probably going to want to go and install things like Facebook, Twitter, anything else that you know you use but you haven't actually come pre-installed. Your search option up at the top here will allow you to search for anything you like Facebook for instance. And you can also, if you're in the mood to browse around, if you come back to your main apps list here, this is where Google kind of highlights the apps that you might be most interested in. So there's plenty of Christmas apps around at the moment, obviously. From here, you can also access games recommended by the staff and the editor's choice. And these just provide you a little bit more information. These tend to be some of the best apps on the App Store. But you don't just want what everyone else is recommending on Google. What you want to do is go and actually have a look through. So if you swipe on the Play Store to the right, swipe to the right, you can bring up the sections list. And in here, you've got all sorts of different app categories. So education, entertainment, finance, games, books, medical stuff, sports. So if, for instance, you want sports, let's go into the sports category. And you can then see all of the top paid apps, all of the top free apps, the top apps that are grossing, so that's the amount of money the app has made. If an app has in-app purchases, it might allow the app to be free, but the app can still make money and it would appear in this list. Top new paid, finding the latest stuff that's come up that's to pay for. And the top new free, same principle, but it's free. And worthwhile having a good scroll through all these, look at some of the reviews, see what the apps are like. And then, you know, once you've decided, install the application. Quick and easy. Some of the apps that I really find useful are things like AppyGeek if you're interested in getting hold of the latest tech news, but also things like the magazines and the music. You can now pull down all of your music from your Google Cloud or buy music from Google and store that in the cloud there as well. Same with your magazines. There's now 30-day subscriptions if you're in the UK, so you can test out the magazines before you actually commit to a long-term subscription with them. And also books are now available as well. So if you've got any books that you've bought from the Kindle store or anything like that, you get to buy them all over again on Google Books. Hooray! If you're a first-time Google Books user, you're going to find it a really nice experience on the Galaxy Note 2. The text is very, very crisp and it's a beautiful reading experience on the large screen. Some of the other things that you should have a look at is Modern Combat 4, fantastic if you're into games. Total War Battles, another fantastic game as well. A lot of the Samsung apps, you may notice that you've got a Samsung App Store there. It's very similar to the Google Play Store. Not an awful lot of difference, other than you'll find some apps are on offer there and not quite such a large range of choice. But a good place to have a quick look and see what Samsung are offering, either cheap or free to Samsung Galaxy users. You'll always find a couple of apps in there. Other than that, Google Calendar is a very useful app. You won't generally get a Google Calendar on the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. It has Samsung's own calendar app, but I actually quite like the Google experience, so Google Calendar's well worth getting. The other app that you should definitely get, I don't actually think I've got it installed, yep, there it is. It may not come pre-installed, but Google Chrome. The default browser, which is just known as browser, or Samsung browser, I think, it's not very good and it doesn't sync up well with your desktop and things like that. If you install Google Chrome and you use Google on your desktop, you'll be easily able to pull up bookmarks and, you know, your last thing you were looking at on one device and the other. Works very nicely. For instance, I can start browsing something on my desktop and walk away from the desktop, fire up Chrome on my phone, and exactly where I left off is available on my phone. A really, really nice way to kind of handle things. And one of the final things that you're really going to want to take a look at here is the Google Now system. If you long press on this button here, it will also bring up your running tasks list. And one of the options is this center button called Google Now. So with Google Now, it personalizes itself really to your life. So if you search for particular things, or if you have friends with birthdays, or you're going somewhere for the day, you've made reservations like travel tickets or things like that, or you go to the cinema a lot, Google Now will prompt you with useful information that will kind of help you. So for instance, here's some friends' birthdays. I can just swipe those out of the way. Here's the weather where I currently am, and it's showing me the next few days. Likewise, if I'd done a search for a hotel or a restaurant, I might have done the search and then kind of forgotten about the restaurant. That information will actually appear in here. Likewise, if I was to make a hotel reservation, Google will notice in my Gmail that I've made a reservation, and it will then provide that reservation information here for me, so it's quickly and easily accessible. But also, it doesn't stop there with Google now. If I want, I can make a voice search. What is the capital of England?
London is the capital of England.
And there you have it. So you can make voice searches. Basically, it's like Apple Siri, but much better done, because it's drawing on real rich data held within your Google account. Some people say a bit creepy. Personally, I find it a very, very cool user feature, and it saved me an awful lot of time. One of the great things I like about it is, once it learns where home is, anytime you're out and about travelling, if you have it programmed for traffic, for instance, it will check and see what the traffic is going to be like between where you currently are and where home is, and it will then tell you if you need to either leave more time or use a diversion, and it can then plot all of that information for you on a Google map. Very, very cool. But there is a couple of quick and simple things to do with your brand new Samsung Galaxy Note 2 on Christmas Day.